honey. Blip, 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 blip. Honey, honey.
Ward, ward, ward.
Honey, honey. Honey, honey. Why don't you sharpen that?
Talking to a hungry guy.
All you musicians are hungry. Go on.
That's right. And so many of them eat. And then they're the ones who don't eat. Well, ladies and gentlemen, just focus on this one fact. I'm pretending to call room service right now at an imaginary hotel that we can't name because they don't sponsor our program. But there's still hope for them. However, ladies and gentlemen, just pretend that he's working in the kitchen and I'm up in my lonely little rock and roll musician's room.
Stop burning those beans!
Stop burning those beans.
I'm in the kitchen, you know.
Why don't you sharpen it then?
You gotta control these pilgrims in the kitchen, you know. They'll burn the beans.
Hello, is this room service? Look, I'm so hungry. I'm so hungry.
What would you like?
I want to eat.
Anything you want to eat, you can get it here.
I want a green hocker.
Let me write this down. One green hocker.
In a greyhound locker.
In a greyhound locker. You musicians sure have some strange requests.
Yeah,
well. Do the room service and hit the please. Go on.
That's right. I want a green hocker and a greyhound locker.
One green hocker and a greyhound locker.
Smoking.
Smoking.
In the pygmy twilight. You do aim to please, don't you?
We're burning that sucker up.
We's burning that sucker up. Listen to that.
Notice the equal.
How you do go on.
Let me tell you. Is that all you want? You don't want no meat?
No.
Don't you want some meat?
Oh, no.
Want some meat?
So I got some meat.
Wait a minute.
Here's the deal.
You shouldn't talk about our room service unless you taste it first. You gotta taste it first.
Oh, well, I'm very anxious to taste it. However, I'm not finished giving you my order, okay?
What else would you like?
I want you to concentrate. Just let your mind drift back to the first part of the order. It's a green hawker and a greyhound locker smoking in the pygmy twilight. And I want to avoid the garni du jour. I never eat the garni du jour.
You don't?
No.
What about the dogs?
No, listen.
We gotta eat.
I haven't told you about the dogs yet.
I saw you when you registered. Don't tell me.
The dog.
Caravan of dogs.
Uh-uh.
Oh, those are two bookers.
The dogs did not register with me.
Oh, okay.
There's only one person the dogs register with.
I knew they were with your troop, but I didn't know which one.
And he used to have a suit on, gorilla hair on it. Now look, I want to avoid the wrinkled carrot.
Okay, no wrinkled carrot.
No thin wrinkled carrot, no celery.
No twisted celery.
No parsley.
No parsley.
No salad that's so soggy that you don't want to get there.
No salad with saran wrap on top.
I don't want any styrofoam cups.
No styrofoam.
I don't want any styrofoam knives and forks.
No paper plates.
No paper plates.
Then we're gonna serve you on China. This time it's gonna be on genuine China.
I must have come to the right hotel this time.
Do the room service. Listen, anything you need.
During the last show, the room service wasn't quite this good, but I know that I'm really gonna get it this time.
Well, now look, we do try harder, you know.
Along with the green hawker and the greyhound locker smoking in the pygmy twilight, I would like to have a crystal eye.
One crystal eye.
A crystal eye. That's
one
two
more crystal
eyes.
Eye.
That's right. And a crystal kidney.
And one crystal kidney. You know, that's just about like liver, you know. It was shining, though.
Yeah.
Yeah, you know, so if you want it.
Yeah, I want it.
All right.
I want it. I don't want you to be burning that sucker up, though.
Wait a minute. You said you wanted to smoke it.
No, not the kidney.
Oh, okay.
Okay, I want you to send this to room 33.
Room 33, that's right, after 4. 4-4.
No, 4-4 is somebody else.
Oh, okay, 3-3.
That's Chester's room.
I must be in 4-5 then, and Duke must be in 4-3. The way Marty registers all the Orientals in this group. Here we go. What else?
Yeah, well, you'll be able to recognize me. I'm in room 3-3, and I'm right next to room 3-4. All
right.
And 3-4 is the room that's got the smell of the dog coming out of it.
Well, I know you won't miss that.
Okay.
The person I'm sending up is familiar with that odor.
You know?
Yes,
why?
Is.
Because he's from Baltimore?
No, because he has a little beard, and he's, his office is in the motel building, and on and on. Well, okay.
You're trying to tell me that this guy is so swift that my order is going to get up there right away?
They call him Slick for short.
Slick for short?
When he don't have shorts, they still call him Slick.
Okay, well, I want you to send him up because I sure am hungry.
Listen here. Matter of fact, so you won't get the wrong guy, I'm going to tell you who we're going to be sending up. You know who we're going to send up to you with your fabulous order up to your room?
Zack, Zack, Zack Glickman.
Drive a little puny car.
Zack, Zack, Zack Glickman.
Throws out a dollar phone real good.
Service?
Yes.
Look here, I want you to dummy up because my food ain't got here yet, you know?
Is this room 3-3?
That's room 3-3,
your
you know,
food
next
didn't
to 3.
Get that?
No, it never got here. That guy from Baltimore that you sent up just didn't make it, you know?
It was a case of bad judgment. I'll try to
Listen, I'm gonna get very angry with you. I'm going to call Herb if the food doesn't come right away.
Hey. Matter of fact, I tell you what we can do. So we'll make sure the food does get there and that you don't get any advances. And for that matter, so you don't get too much food for the price you're paying. You know who we're going to send the food up by?
No, who are you going to send the food up by?
We're going to send the food up by one and only Curtis Cat. Hey, Coleman. You know he's got a little hair.
Hey, Coleman.
Kind of cute when he curls, did you know?
Coleman.
Walks around with his door advances.
You know, the food finally got here, and
I knew I could depend on him, you know, because he's got it down to the hundreds of a second.
Yeah, I know. Herb does have it down to the hundreds of a second. Well, you know, I think we've exhausted the possibilities of this routine. Do you suggest we end the song?
Either that or get Mart up here to dance. I mean, you know.
Oh, wait a minute. Mart, come here. Mart,
come on.
Come
Mart.
On.
Come on, Mart.
No,
don't
look, you,
come
can,
on,
you can fill out the after
don't
contract later.
Mart. So, yow.
Ladies and gentlemen, I want to introduce you to, this is Mort Leboff. Mort Leboff, De La Baltimore, who is the producer of the show, and he would like to sing to you right now.
Wow.
Good God, ain't it funky now?
Give me that wine.
Here, I'll make it easy.
Oh, give me that wine.
We're gonna make it easy on you, Mort. All you have to do is sing your own name on the offbeats. You ready?
All right, here we go.
If this show ever goes on television, and if this show ever galls, if it ever galls to Arbutus, if it ever goes to Baltimore, if it ever goes to Haverty Grace, to all those fine places, I want all the people in that wretched state of Maryland to understand one thing. Mort's from there, Marty's from there, Zach is from there, Chester's from there, and I'm from there too.
What can I tell you?